No weapon formed against me shall prosper. It won't work.
Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, our risen Savior and our soon coming King. Once again, this is Pastor Agnes Williams of Agnes Williams Ministries Kingdom Connections, discussing with you on principles enshrined in the Word of God to enhance your daily living and to bring us in a closer walk with God and to understand your full purpose upon earth, why you were born into that particular family, why you have that particular name. God has a purpose for everyone. Today my topic is true wisdom. True wisdom. And my main scripture is taken from Proverbs chapter 1, verses 1 to 7. Proverbs chapter 1, verses 1 to 7. And I'm reading from the NIV version. It says here, the Proverbs of Solomon, son of David, king of Israel, for attaining wisdom and discipline, for understanding words of insight, for acquiring a disciplined and prudent life, doing what is right and just and fair, for giving prudence to the simple, knowledge and discretion to the young. Let the wise listen and add to their learning. Let the discerning get guidance for understanding proverbs and parables, the sayings and riddles of the wise. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and discipline. True wisdom. Let's pray. Father, I thank you today for another opportunity to share with your people from your word. Holy Spirit, let me share today just what you want the hearers to hear, to uplift them, to bring them closer to you, to understand God more, and to be able to live a better life or a closer walk with God, pleasing God each day and fulfilling their true purpose in life. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Today I really wanted to address my message to the young at heart. First of all, the young age. And I'm thinking about from 15 years to 35 years. Because we have found that in that age bracket, there are young people who are bewildered by life. Sometimes they are confused. Sometimes their very birth confuses them. The nature of their upbringing confuses them. Life itself is a matter of confusion and no understanding, and sometimes there's no one to explain to them. But I want to give our youth assurance today that even in this present world, you can get guidance and wisdom from the Word of God. And if you would want to understand, take 1 month and every day read one chapter in the book of Proverbs in the Holy Scriptures and let the Holy Spirit teach you. You can use any different versions you want, all the different versions, and check. And I guarantee you at the end of that 1 month, you will be a wiser person. You'll have a closer understanding of God, of your purpose in life, and what life is all about. But true wisdom comes from Almighty God. Sometimes we go to study, oh yes, we need a higher education. We go to universities, we go to our community colleges, we get our associate degrees, we get our diplomas, then we get our bachelor's, then we get our master's, then we get our doctorate. And sometimes we think, having acquired all of that, we are wise. All those accomplishments are very important. Because if that's what God has for you, pursue those dreams. But in all you're getting, ensure that you look to the Word of God and to eternal God for true wisdom. Because it's only then when you look to God, God can utilize or use the education you've acquired that you can fulfill your purpose to its maximum upon earth here. And so please God and be ready for your eternal home when He calls you home. Because you were born with a purpose. And it is not always evident early in life. But as you travel along life, as you follow God's leading, your parents' guidance, your teacher's guidance, and you seek to do the right thing, gradually your purpose would be manifested. Some people made from the day they were born, born to be a king. Well, okay, I'm supposed to be a king. But others have to work it through by the grace of God and by others who've gone before, who God has placed in their lives. And God places mentors and leaders in your life, not because they are there to oppress you, but to guide you, young people, to guide you in the way. I mean, I'm not saying sometimes the adults, no adult does everything right. But look for those who have integrity, those who are trying to do the right thing and follow those people. Sometimes even the worst sin out there has a good word of advice for you, because they have sinned and they have messed up and their life has been destroyed. They can tell you, I went this way and it wasn't the right way. You, as a young person, you have a chance to go the right way, follow God, go God's way, do the right things. Don't get involved in crime. Don't get involved in violence. Don't get involved in hatred and anger. So sometimes a vagrant can tell you something and give you some words of wisdom to guide you along your way. Don't despise any word of wisdom that comes from anyone, because God inspires all man at times to speak to you anyway. He made a dumb jackass speak to Balaam. And if he can do that, he can do that to you also. So true wisdom is found in the word of God. Solomon wrote this. It is said that Solomon was principally the person who wrote Proverbs. God had said that Solomon was one of the, there would be no other man or other king in this world as great as Solomon. He was great in wisdom and riches. He was the greatest of all because God made him so. And that was after David had sinned and repented and turned back to God. So these Proverbs that we have here, the book of Proverbs, it tells you everything about life. There's always something in the book of Proverbs about every aspect of life. It teaches you how to live, how to walk in obedience to your parents, not to hate, to love and to forgive. It teaches you about business, teaches you about hygiene, correct behavior in government, at school, at play. Let's look at some of the things here. Chapter 1 tells us about, you're warned about being enticed by sinful people. People would take you down a pathway like doing drugs, coke, marijuana, crime, shooting people, robbing people, cursing people. You know, from verses 8 down to chapter 19 in chapter 1, it tells us here, you are warned against being enticed by sinful people who do sinful things. First it says, listen, my son, to your father's instructions, and do not forsake your mother's teachings. So even from a child, Proverbs is telling you that your parents would guide you in the right way. They would instruct you, they would correct you, they would nurture you. And so children ought to be obedient to their parents. Oh yes, we have some parents who are delinquent, but my parents were never perfect, but they tried their best. And I learned a lot from my parents. As I get older, I realize, oh, my parents instilled these habits in me, these good habits, these good sayings. They took me to church, they taught me the word of God. They wouldn't go sometimes, but they taught me the word of God. They encourage you to pray, encourage you to worship God. So we are warned, young people, you are warned against being enticed to do wrong things. Further in the chapter, you are warned against rejecting wisdom. Verse 20 says, wisdom calls aloud in the street. She raises her voice in the public squares. At the head of the noisy street, she cries out. In the gates of the city, she makes a speech. So sometimes people are talking and they are saying things all the way around life. And there are words of wisdom that are ensuing from these people's mouth that we can, from which we can learn. Sometimes you learn about business from the ordinary man on the street who might be selling similar trinkets. And you ask him, how does he survive? And he will tell you. And you can learn from that. And you can become a better businessman, coupled with your educational training, your university training, and other books that you might have read too, other advice. So you are warned about rejecting wisdom. Lord, don't we see there is wisdom for the upright? He says, my son, in chapter 2, if you accept my words and store up my commands within you, turning your ear to wisdom and applying your heart to understanding, and if you call out for insight and cry out for understanding, and if you look for it as for silver and search for it as for hidden treasure, then you will understand the fear of the Lord and find the knowledge of God. It says, for the Lord gives wisdom, in verse 6, New NIV version. For the Lord gives wisdom, and from his mouth come knowledge and understanding. So true wisdom comes from Almighty God. And he has allowed men to write in the Holy Scriptures, giving us all ways, means, aspect, how we can become wise. Because God is a wise God. And he wants us to be wise, that we be able to manage our lives, fulfill his purpose, live a pleasing life to him and our fellow men. And at the end of our days or whenever it is, we will have pleased and please God, fulfill our purpose, and inherit eternal life. As we continue looking at Proverbs, wisdom brings blessings. When you follow the path of wisdom, you will have long life. It says, my son, do not forget my teaching, but keep my commands in your heart, for they will prolong your life with many years and bring you prosperity. Talks about love and faithfulness. Never let love and faithfulness leave you. You know, sometimes people, somebody does you something. Somebody is always doing somebody something. And you retaliate with hatred for that person. And you're going to spite them in every aspect of life you can. You try to put blockades in their way for them to get a job, for them to get anything where you have authority, you spite them. That's not wise, and that's not being loving. That's not being forgiving. Wherever you can help someone, even if it's your enemy, you help them. Because God has put you in a position of power and authority, not to oppress people, but to help them to attain their purpose. And when you treat them with love, forgiveness, and kindness, they will see the God in you. And the wisdom of God will shine forth from you, and that can make them turn from their evil ways and turn to God. Youths out there is hope for you in this world based on the word of God. If you search the Proverbs, you see all advice and counsel God has given us there for you to live a successful life. And I dare you to try it and see. Study Proverbs and try to put into practice what you've seen there. And at the end of 1 year, I would like you to report to me and tell me, did it work? Or did it not work? Make sure you pray to God, you give your life to the Lord. It won't be easy. I'm not young anymore, and I know it wasn't easy. But when I look back and see how far God has brought me from, and I see how far I have to go, so I say, thank you, God. You have been faithful. You have guided me through all the changing scenes of time. You have been there. All these good times, the bad times, you were there. You know how to turn the bad times into good. How to let me see to learn from the bad times. And the wisdom of God prevailed in everything. Because when God gives advice, and you follow his advice, you are being wise. When the older people give you advice and you follow the advice, you are being wise. When your peers give you good advice and you follow it, you are being wise. When your teachers speak to you at school, it's not wise, young people, to curse your teachers and behave rude and insolent. And I'm going to a little higher, wives and husbands. God has a way of dealing with us. Sometimes the husband will tell the wife something, and the wife, we wives, will be quick to retort and retaliate. Sometimes it's good. Just don't answer. Don't give him a dirty look. Keep your face plain and straight, just as it was. Don't twitch your lip. Don't say a word. Just leave him into the hands of God, and your children will see the goodness of God in you. They'll see discipline. They'll see self-constraint. They'll see obedience and humility. And in the long run, when God works it out, that husband has to repent either to God or to you. And then things work out. It's not always just to answer back and to shrug your shoulder and give him a bad eye and say this. No, 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 especially. And I'm saying to parents today, to parents, be careful how you react in front of your children. Wives, especially we women, we tend to be so verbose and we tend to show attitude. Sometimes you just stay quiet. I had to learn to do that many times. Learn to do that. You go to a function with your husband and he's there and he's flirting with all these members of the staff with whom he works and he leaves you alone. What do you do? Go up to him and make noise? No, young people, no old people. I just quietly sat there, spoke with other people, and see him doing things. And the Lord said, and then he came and he told me something stupid. And I was about to retort. The Lord said, don't you dare give him any answer or change the look on your face. Listen and say nothing. I will deal. He said, God will deal with him. So I can talk from experience when we have to use wisdom. You don't embarrass your husband in public. If he wants to embarrass you in public, let him look like the fool. Husband, if your wife wants to embarrass him, let her look like the fool. Because if you're a servant of God and you trust in God, that person will have to come to a point to repent. Maybe not to you, but to repent to God, and they should repent to you later on. Because God deals with those kind of things on a person-to-person basis. I know it from experience. So young people, when you see adults behaving funny, don't curse them and unseemly. You just do the right thing. Say a prayer for them and ask God, what can I learn from that experience there that I can take into my own life? Young people at school, you need an education. There is no place in this world for an uneducated boy or girl. Some people leave high school and they can't read, they can't write, they can't spell. Even if you have left high school, I would advise you, because of wisdom, go to remedial classes. There are adult classes. Don't be ashamed to say, I can't read properly, I can't pronounce the words properly, because sometimes in the mass of the class, you get left behind, even in primary school. But you can educate yourself. You can become wise. Wisdom will teach you. Seek further knowledge, seek further help. Back to our scriptures again. In another area, we see here in chapter 4, there's a fatherly advice on the importance of wisdom. He says here, listen, my sons, to a father's instruction. Pay attention and gain understanding. I give you sound the learning, so do not forsake my teaching. When I was a boy in my father's house, still tender, an only child of my mother, he taught me and said, lay hold of my words with all your heart and keep my commands and you will live. Get wisdom and get understanding. So we see, no matter how bad you think your father and mother could be, God instills in them some aspect of wisdom to teach you. And you are to honor your parents. Yes, you don't have to do the bad things they do, you have to honor them. They are your parents. Your mother bore you, she could have squeezed your head at birth and make sure you didn't come. She could have aborted you, but she brought you. And you are to be a catalyst to assist your parents to find the truth in God if they do not know. In a simple, humble way, God will teach you. You can be a catalyst to bring your parents to the knowledge of Jesus Christ once you have found him, to the knowledge of God. I know every family has one like that. Are you that one? To use the wisdom of God, the true wisdom of God, to help your family, your parent? You think you have an erring father and mother? Are you praying for them? Do you love them despite what they do because you don't know what caused them to be what they are? Let wisdom prevail in your life. We go on to chapter 5. It says there's warning against adultery and fornication. You know, sometimes people can get enticed to do wrong things. It's not your will to do something wrong, but you fall into the wrong company with the wrong companion, and you're enticed to do the thing that you never wanted to do. Wisdom will tell you how to get away from those people. Wisdom will tell you, don't listen to the flattering words of that woman, young man. Don't listen to the flattering words of that person to lead you into sin. Right? There's an answer for everything in Proverbs as written in the Word of God. There's warning against laziness in chapter 6. We tend to be lazy. All of us have a little bit of laziness. But if you look here, it tells you how not to be lazy, how to be industrious. You don't have to kill yourself working, but you have to do something to get something. You don't just sit back and get something. You have to put something in. If you want to get corn, you have to get the corn plant. You have to prepare the soil, get the corn seed, and plant the corn. You have to weed it, clean it, water it, nurture it, and then when it grows up, it brings you fruit. It's the same thing, anything you want to achieve in life. There's a process. And laziness has no part with wisdom. Verse 6 says, go to the ant, thou sluggard. Consider its ways and be wise. He said, the ant has no commander, no overseer, no ruler. Yet the ant stores up its provisions in the summer and gathers its food in the harvest so that at winter time they will get food to eat. So you see that? They have natural wisdom built into them. And it goes on. There are 7 things that the Lord hates. And the 6, they are like this. In haughty eyes, a lying tongue, hands that shed innocent blood, a heart that devises wicked schemes, feet that are quick to rush into evil, a false witness who pours out lies, and a man who stirs up dissension or contention among brothers or brethren. So we see here, there are 7 things that God hates. God hates those things. Are you prone to lying? Are you prone to carrying news on others? Are you prone to want to kill someone physically? Are you prone to plan wicked things in your heart for other people because they did you that? He did me that, so I'll do him that. No, youths, don't follow that. Even if you see the adults do it, don't do it. It's not the way of wisdom. Are you a false witness? Some people take pleasure in telling, being a false witness against someone in the courts or in anything, just to bring that person down. Always speak the truth. And sometimes there are people who deliberately sow discord and dissension among families, brothers and sisters. That's not good enough. God hates those things. We don't do those things. And so if you want to get wisdom, study the Word of God. Study the Proverbs. I encourage you, every day in the month, read one chapter of Proverbs. There are 31 chapters. And some of our days, our months have 31 days. And you study it carefully. Use your dictionary. Use your concordance. And see what is the meaning of some of the things. And prayerfully ask God to teach you about wisdom. Wisdom, true wisdom, comes from God. You may look around in the world, around in the working world, and you realize to succeed, you have to tell lies on your friends, you have to eavesdrop, you have to do underhand things to them. You might hide the files, you might shred the important letter. Don't do that. You will speak them with their very friends. Don't do that. That's not love. That's not wisdom. Wisdom will teach you, don't do that. Don't give an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. Show people love. When you show love, you show that you're of God. Show them forgiveness. If you have to do something for someone, do it without fear or favor. Not because he's my neighbor and we had some dispute. He came to you in your position in an office. He has to say about this. Treat him or her with the same respect and attention as you would do anybody else. Do your job without fear or favor. Wisdom will cause you. When you do that, God stores up those things in his books and he rewards you in the long run. So today I want to tell you about wisdom. Wisdom, true wisdom, is found in the Word of God. True wisdom is found in God. And so, if you want to get true wisdom, check the book of Proverbs, and you will find true wisdom there. God bless you. The world is much brighter. If you're tired of the crying, come on. If you're tired of people.